Hello, welcome to Dungeon Girls Podcast. I'm your host, Justin. So, I watched the new James Wan film, which came out on September 10th. It's Malignant, and it's a 2021 horror thriller. It's an hour and 51 minutes. It stars Annabelle Wallis as Madison, Ingrid Bishu as Winnie, don't remember this character, McKenna, sorry, that's the young Madison, Maddie Hasson as Sydney Lake. Show me cast members that were actually in a majority of the movie, not people who were big names, but only in like one or two scenes. Like, come on. If you can call anybody in this movie like big actors, because the only actor in this movie who was recognizable to me was from Boston Legal, Dan. And I'm not talking about like William Shatner or James Spader. other cast members. You got George Young as Detective Kakoa Shaw, Michelle Brianna White as Regina Moss, Jacqueline McKenzie as Dr. Florence Weaver, and Kristen Clemenson as Dr. Victor Fields, who is the actor I'm talking about. So, this movie is written by Akil Cooper, who worked on Luke Cage, and she worked on Jupiter's Legacy, which I hated that show. Loved the comic book, hated the show. This movie, here's the thing about this movie. I wanted to like it. I'm a huge James Wan fan, and boy, I was not impressed with the movie, though there is some cool things in the film. Like, the music was great, the cinematography was great, there's action scenes in this movie, and the design of the killer, right, Gabriel, is fantastic, and I like some of the, visuals in the film where, you had this, without spoiling stuff, I can't get into specifics, but my problem with the movie, right, is you have lack of star power, hardly any recognizable actors whatsoever, and what actors that were in the film, I didn't think they were doing a good job, honestly, right? Another recognizable actor in this film, who's not even listed here, is Zoe Bell, who is this Australian stunt woman that's married to Quentin Tarantino. She's in the movie for like one random scene, right? Which that scene was really good, but it's like, wow, what the hell is she doing in this movie? Right, so people don't know what the movie is about. It's basically a mystery film, right? Where this woman who you think is at first being haunted by a ghost is actually being tormented by this character who you don't exactly know is either real or a split personality or something, which I don't want to spoil the twist of the film, because I was half right on the twist, which is another problem. The movie is very predictable, right? Yeah. And the story is basically, our main character has a mysterious past, and a figure from her past is going around getting revenge on the people that he feels wronged him, and at the same time getting back at our main character who he feels has abandoned her and wants to kill the people closest to her, which is her younger sister, right? And like, she's actually adopted, right? But how it is. I thought Gabriel was a really cool character, and some of the action scenes with him was great. Like, the scenes where he's walking backwards and like his contortionist, like they his contortion that he does with the body is really cool, right? But like I said, like the movie feels like it's all flash, little substance with the story and the characters, and there's like feminist stuff in the movie as well, where like our out of nowhere our character gets the upper hand with the villain, and it makes no fucking sense. Makes little to no sense, because like he's basically mind fucking her with her powers, and somehow she's able to use the powers that he had that she had no idea that she also had against him, and it makes no sense, dude. And the movie's sequel bait, which I honestly wouldn't mind seeing, like, Gabriel in more movies, but yeah, man. This main character, I really don't like her or the other characters. And the acting, I thought, was really weak, but there's some really cool visual stuff. There's a great action scene where Gabriel's locked up and he escapes, and, like, he kills everybody in like lockup, and like takes on every cop at a police station. That was a great action scene. That reminded me of something from like Aquaman, but which James Wan also directed. But if it was R-rated, and there's lots of cool gore in the film, right? And I don't want to talk about the plot twist, but like I would say it was pretty cool. But like I can kind of. It was really cool, but I was kind of half right where I did. I was somewhat close to the plot twist, right? Which I don't want to get into. But, like, yeah, if you're a fan, I would say this. If you're a fan of body horror and you like really visually cool, like, you know, killers and cool killers, and, like, Gabriel's voice is really cool. It reminded me of the Ghostface killer from the Scream movies, where he has a really very cool, seductive, like, you know, voice. Like, that was very badass, right? Right. So I would say, yeah, like, check out the movies, like, everywhere, basically, because it was, I think it, you had the same, I think it was also released on HBO Max, because it's like, you can find this movie on a lot of websites, by the way. Which I'm not saying you should pirate the film. I'm just saying if you want to check it out, yeah. But honestly, my rating for this film is like a 6 out of 10. The music was great, the visuals were great, but I thought the story and the characters were lacking, and there was hardly any star power. And the fact that they put this movie out in September instead of October means they didn't think the movie was that great to begin with. Yeah, so I'm only giving it a 6 out of 10, and I probably. Besides from, like, maybe checking out scenes from Gabriel on YouTube, I probably wouldn't rewatch this movie again. Yeah. All right, guys, that's it for this.